Together we pray to Allah Ta'ala. Our times are days, a duty upon us. So never delay from the blessings of Allah. Don't turn away.
Yet again, the hadith is in Tirmizi. The companion of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is sitting down, and he says that I seen Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the masjid. He says, I was looking at the face of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then I was looking at the moon, then I was looking at the face of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then I was looking at the moon. Every time I was looking at the moon, my eyes were fixed on the face of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why? Because his face was more beautiful than the moon. This is the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam that the whole world should be following. This is the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam that the Muslim of the 21st century should be taking as a role model. Why? Because Adam alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Shish alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Nuh alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Ibrahim alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Ismail alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Ishaq alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Yaqub alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Musa alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Yusha alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Daniel alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Yunus alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Ayyub alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Dawood alayhi salam was sent to one nation, Yahya alayhi salam was sent to one nation. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam surpassed a lot of them, and he was sent to the whole of mankind. This is the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam that the whole world should be following. The best of examples that ever stepped on this face of this earth was none other than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Why is it that the Muslims are ashamed to act upon the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Why is it that the Muslims of the 21st century are ashamed to act upon the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? If they're not ashamed to grow dreadlocks under the armpits and between their thighs, then why are you ashamed to keep the beard? If they're not ashamed to walk half naked on the streets, then why are you ashamed to wear the hijab or the niqab properly? If they're not ashamed to commit sin in public, then why are you ashamed to pray salah on the streets? If they're not ashamed to jump in the pool naked, then why are you ashamed to do wudu in the toilet sinks? This is who you are. You are the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and do not underestimate Allah's power. Why? Because Allah indeed has tested people before you. Allah has tested the people of the 21st century in foreign countries. People are killed, people are raped. Muslim women are forced to have intercourse with their own sons. Fathers are forced to have intercourse with their own daughters. Their skin have been peeled from their bodies. Don't make Allah test you people in this way. You've got Islam on your plate. You could practice Islam. Hold firm upon the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Obey Allah and obey his messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is who you are. So what if we eat with our hands? This is who we are. So what if we sit down and urinate? This is who we are. So what if we grow the beard? This is who we are. So why if the Muslim women wear the hijab or the niqab? This is who they are. So why if the Muslim viewers use a stick to brush their teeth? This is who we are. We are Muslims and we are the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And never forget this. Never forget this.